What's up? I've been streaming for a while now, and I've been getting quite a few questions on, how to become a 2D VTuber. So I thought I'd make a video to give a brief insight of what goes on behind the whole process and all that. So if you're looking to commission or make a live 2D model, I hope this video will help. Also, my editing skills kind of shite, so we'll be going the way of the PowerPoint. And with that out of the way, let's begin. Alright, so here's the basic flowchart of the process. You start with character design, then you or an artist that you commissioned does the character art. Then that art gets rigged in live 2D by someone that you commissioned. Or if you have the patience, you could actually learn live 2D and do it yourself. Then the model from Live 2D gets its movements controlled through motion capture technology. Yeah. So, let's take a closer look at character design. Okay, so I feel that this part is a given, but I'll go over it anyways. Artist or not, you'll need to know how you want your character to look. Hair color, hairstyle, clothing, personality, special features, that stuff. Having art of your character, especially concept art, will help your artist a bunch. If you don't have any of that, I'd recommend using a character creator like PicCrew, or even in-game character generators to give your artist an idea of what you want. Inspiration pictures or even a crude drawing can also help, I guess. And yeah, I guess that's it for character design. So now we're on to character art. This is the actual art that will be used for your model. First off, if you're an artist, I'd actually recommend doing this part yourself like I did. Because, well, I'm broke. I mean, it saves you money, so might as well, right? You'll also learn how to set up art for the rigging process, which can be useful if you want to go back and edit your model, or add things like accessories like this, or an alt outfit like that. And I think it gives your character your own personal touch. Now that I think of it, Hololive Suisei did the art for her first model, right? Now, if you can't draw, the other option is to seek out and commission artists. You'll have to make sure that you or your artist knows how to separate the art into proper layers and parts. And to do that, I'd recommend searching up YouTube videos or tutorials on that. There's a bunch out there. You can also go on Live2D's website and download a sample PSD to pick apart and learn. Things to look out for when making your art is that the art should be in PSD format, and generally you'd want the character to be drawn facing the camera head-on, like a portrait shot. It's best to work with high-resolution artwork to maintain good quality when zooming in. And you should look out for transparency gaps and stray pixels, because you wouldn't want your character to have see-through holes and floaty bits in your model. And here we are at the rigging part. Live2D is basically the software that allows one to make drawings move. You can commission someone to rig for you, or you could learn it yourself. Live2D has a free version, and it's good enough for a bust or half-body avatar, I believe. If you have the time and patience, I'd recommend checking out Brian Sui's video tutorials. Live2D also has official resources as well. There's also a Live2D community Discord out there, and it's great for technical help and resources. It's also a good place to check out if you're looking to commission someone for your Live2D art and rigging. I'll link below. So, once your model is ready, you'll need software with motion capture capabilities. I'm currently using FaceRig. And for now, FaceRig seems to be the most popular choice for Live2D motion capture. You'll also need to buy the Live2D module for your avatar to work. Oh, and this should be an obvious one, but you'll need a webcam. There are other alternatives to FaceRig out there, but they're not well known. But another VTuber, Neo Trinity, has made a spreadsheet of available face tracking software. I'll link it below. Might give them a try myself eventually. And that's about it for this video. There are different approaches to take when going about making virtual avatars, but this is basically what I went through. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below. And if you found this video to be useful, please do consider liking and subscribing. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.